So my VirtualBox's VM IP keeps on changing frequently whenever I do a restart of that VM, or in between also sometimes it gets changed. It doesn't happen regularly, but then it happens most of the time. The IP gets changed. I wanted to use as a static IP because I have some softwares installed in there and I want to be able to remember that IP address. So how can we do that? In this session, we will see how we can fix the IP address to be static in my CentOS VM, which is running in a virtual box.
I'm Kumar and welcome to my channel on tech and tutorials.
So my CentOS VM's IP gets changed, but I haven't seen the Ubuntu 20 machine's IP got changed ever, but whenever it changes, I will do the same for that as well. In this session, we will see how we can fix for this CentOS VM to not change its IP and keep it as static so that I'm able to access the same IP whenever I want to. Okay, so first let us see the configuration of this CentOS which is already running. We'll go to the settings for this CentOS, and if you see on the networks, I have two networks. One is the NAT adapter, which is by default. You cannot access anything from the outside. You can only log in through this console, VirtualBox's console, and you can work on that. And the other one is the bridged adapter, so that you are able to SSH to the CentOS machine, and then you can access the internet, and it will be assigned an IP address. Nowadays, most people are working from home, and we have our ISPs provide our internet, and it gets the IP assigned through my ISP. Let us go to the command prompt. And see what is the IP my ISP has assigned. Basically, it will be a private IP address, but we can check that IP config, and you should see that my IP address for this host machine where I'm running this Windows is 192.168.1.5, and then the subnet mask is 255.255.255.255.0. Okay, so this is good. So I will have to assign something within this range of 192.168.1.something for my VirtualBox VM. So first let us see what is the IPs it got, and we are going to change this bridged adapter's IP address. And you can see my setting in here. It's the default setting here. There is no changes which I have changed. It's bridged adapter, and then other wireless Wi-Fi adapter, and then the other things remains the same. Net connection, I haven't changed anything. I also just left it, but I usually don't use this net connection. It just is the one which VirtualBox has created, and adapter 2 is the one which I have enabled after installing this CentOS so that my host machine is able to connect using SSH to the CentOS machine. So let us log in to this machine. Now the IP which it has got is 192.168.1.12. If you go to the CentOS host guest machine IP address, you should see an IP of here 192.168.1.12 and the other network IP address and configuration. I'll minimize this for now, and since I log into the SSH console of this machine, I can see it from here. If config. So by the way, if config command doesn't come by default in CentOS machine, you have to do a yum install nettools, something like yum install net -tools, and you will get the if config command in a CentOS machine. So by default, you can do IPA, and it will give you the IP addresses of this host. Okay, so this is the network, and this is the IP 192.168.1.12. So I'd like to set it as static. So for that, what we need to do is we need to go inside this path, etc sysconfig network scripts, and let me copy and paste it here and then clear the screen. And here you will see the one which is already here, ENP0S3. This is the one which is for the net. The net one has got an IP 10.0.2.15. ENP0S3. Okay, this one didn't change up till now, and anyway, I'm not using this one, so it doesn't matter because I cannot use SSH to this IP address. I can only use SSH to the bridged one, 192.168.1.12. So here what we need to do is we need to create a file here in this folder. You need to be logged in as root, so by default I'm logged in as root, so I have to create one file. So what I will do is I will create the file which is already named by this VM, so vi, and you create this file. And once in this file, what we can do is we can copy this part. You can define the device name, and then boot protostatic on boot, it should be enabled. And the IP address which I am setting is 192.168.1.15. This is my home network and kids and all who are using the internet. So my ISP would be providing 192.168.1.1.2.3.4.5.6.7. Well, probably that many devices my family has, and hopefully kids will not ask to buy more of these iPhones and other devices. But there is a big but here. here that I can't answer. Anyway, you set it as per need. Basically, I would not have around 15 devices. So from starting from 15 would be okay. You can set it to whatever you like, 20, 30, 60, 70, whatever you like, you can set it. So I have just set it as 1.15, and the netmask is something which should be similar to this one. 255.255.255.0. So, and I copy this one and I paste it here. So this is done. So once I save this one and I do the command of restart the network, systemctl restart network, this IP is going to be changed. Sorry, this IP is going to be changed for this host, and it will always have 192.168.1.15. So just paste it and hit enter here. So this console is going to go off. So let us go to the VM's console here and let us see the IP address now. Okay, so the IP which you see here, 192.168.1.15, so it has already set and with this device. And so I will have to open another console, new session, 192.168.1.15, and login as root, IP address, and now you should see that my IP is 1.15. So from next time onwards, whenever I do a restart of my virtual machine, CentOS 7 in this case, I will always get an IP of 192.168.1.15. So if I have installed some servers like Jenkins or any DB server and I have set it in another application, then I don't need to go ahead and change it there every time. So I can have the same IP address always. So before ending this video, I would like also to tell you that once you have changed this IP address, it is always better to reboot this VM so that if you have any other applications or softwares in this VM like Docker and all, it might not work properly. So it's always better to reboot this whole machine so that the whole machine or all the other softwares and all gets restarted properly and gets the proper IP assigned whenever it reboots. Also, another thing is, it might be a problem. So now I'm working from my home, so my IP is most of the time or always going to be 192.168.something. But once I go to some other network, maybe in the office network or any other place, if the DHCP assigns some other IP address other than 192.168, then it might cause a problem there. So in that case, I might need to come ahead and change this IP address in this machine, in this VM. But that's okay, I guess. For now, I will have 192.168 in my machine only, since mostly we will be working from home for quite some time.
That's all in this video. I hope it was helpful to you. Thanks a lot for watching, and please do leave a comment below about this video. Thank you.
And see you in the next video.